Hello my dear students, how are you all? I hope everyone is fine. Yes? So, do you remember last video what we have learned? Yes, we have learned about the electromagnet. Am I right? I have taught you the concept of electromagnet and I have told you to find where we can use the application of electromagnet in our day-to-day life. Can have the examples where we can use the concept of electromagnet? Oh, some might have said yes, some or might have said no. See, I have already discussed about the electromagnet. What is the concept of electromagnet? Electromagnet, the word itself tells you it consists of electricity and a magnet. Are you getting? So electromagnet is a magnet consists of a screw on which we have wounded a copper coin. Through this screw and we have supplied to the cell. And when the switch will be on, that time the screw will behave like a magnet. Are you getting? And say this type of the circuit is called as a electromagnet, where we have, when a current will pass through this wire, at that time this screw will behave like a magnet. Are you getting? And so that it will be easy to attract the magnetic material. So where we can use this concept? So today we are going to learn, in today's video we are going to discuss where we can use this electromagnet concept. If you want to increase the strength or the power of this electromagnet, then what we have to do? See, on the screw we have wounded a copper wire. If we will increase the number of turns of the copper wire, it will get more power to attract the magnetic material. So like that we can increase the strength of the electromagnet, or by increasing the amount of current passing through it. So how we can increase the current? By adding the number of cell, we can increase the power of this circuit, and we can increase the strength of this electromagnet. Are you getting? Then in today's video we are going to learn the uses of electromagnet, where we can use this application. Already we have learned, now we have understood the concept of electromagnet, where we can use via this electromagnet concept we are using in our day-to-day life. The uses of electromagnet. Magnet is used in the crane to lift the heavy object or heavy load. In the many companies such as iron, we use this crane to lift the heavy object. The crane uses the electromagnet. And one more thing, electromagnet is a stronger magnet than the permanent magnet also. So the first use, that it is used in a crane to lift the heavy loads of an object. Now wherever the iron objects in the companies, there are the machineries to carry that machineries, a strong electromagnet is used to lift the load or unload the particular object. We use electromagnet in the crane. Then in motors, electromagnet is also used in a motor, such as, now see, everyone is having the ceiling fan. There is a small motor inside. You can see your small motor is there, am I right? It is used to move the fan, yes or no? So in the fan, in that we use the magnet. So in the fan, mixer, washing machine, the magnet is there which work on the principle of the electromagnetism. Are you getting? Then if suppose there is a much scrap, junk of the scrap of metal, then to separate the iron, we can use the electromagnet. We can use the electromagnet to remove the iron pieces aside or from the junk of the metal scrap. We can use the electromagnet. Then doctor uses the electromagnet. Can you just tell me where we can use? The tiny iron particles can be easily removed by the concept of electromagnet. So doctor uses this. In one more concept, MRI. What is, have you heard the word MRI? Yes, many of the students might have heard. In the doc, many of the students must have heard about MRI. So what is the full form of MRI? Can you just tell me? MRI machine, it is a machine which is used by the doctor. Magnetic resonance imaging. Magnetic resonance imaging. This is a machine which is used to get the image of our particular body part, to get an image of a particular body part, which works on the principle of the electromagnet, which works on the principle of a electromagnet. So MRI machine, which is used by the doctor. Now, use of the electromagnet is also used in electric bell. This electric bell, how the magnet is used in electric bell, that we will learn in the electricity part. But it is also works on the principle of the electromagnet. Electric bell, telephone, we use this concept of electromagnet. Hard disk, audio, video, tapes, we are using the electromagnetic concept. Are you getting? In hard disk, there is one, it used to store the data. What is the use of the hard disk? It is used to store the data. Are you getting? So in that also the magnet is used, the concept of electromagnet. In ATM, airline tickets. Now have you seen the ATM? Now see, I have one ATM. Can you see? See, this is the ATM. You can see this black strip. Can you see this black strip? See, it is made up of magnetic material. In this, all information of the particular person is fitted. In this, all the information of the particular person is fitted. For also we use the concept of electromagnet. Then airline tickets also we use the electromagnet concept. There is one train which works on the principle of electromagnet, that is the train, Mangalore train. Mangalore train, it works on the principle of, or the properties of the electromagnetism and repulsion. It works on the properties of electromagnetism and yes, repulsion. Now how does it happens, that we will see. See, as you know, suppose this is a rail. This is a rail, okay? If the, on this wheel of the train, there are some poles, north, south, north, south, like this are given. And here also north, south, north, south. The bar magnets which are like this. This is north, then here it is south. North, then here it is south, okay? When a train is moving, the speed of this train is very high. The train has a very great speed. How? Because of the repulsion property. When north and north, when it comes together, it moves at a very high speed because the ripple. Ripple means what happens? What is the actual property of repulsion? Repulsion is a property where the when the two poles or the two like poles when come together, it ripples away, it move away. So it makes the train to move very faster. Are you getting? So it works on the principle of the electromagnet and it repulsion property. Are you getting? The Mangalev train works on the property of the electromagnet and the magnetic repulsion. Are you getting? So this was of a magnet. The last point we are going to discuss in the magnet is about how the magnetism is destroyed. Now I have shown you the different types of a magnet. Are you getting? We have learned the different types of the magnet. Is it possible the magnet can lose its magnetism? Yes, when it is heated. When a magnet is heated, it can lose its magnetism. It is hammered. Hammered means, you know what is that? When you heat a magnet, it can lose its magnetism, or when dropped from the height. If the magnet is dropped from a particular height, it can lose its magnetism. So all the magnets, you have to store it properly. You have to store it properly. If the magnets are not stored properly, it can. It can lose its magnetism. If the bar magnets are not stored properly, it can lose its magnetism. So that process, or when it lose a magnetism, that is called as a self-demagnetization. When it loses, if the magnets are not stored properly by us, then what will happen? It can lose its magnetism, and that is called as a self-demagnetization. So what things we have to do? How to take care of the magnet? If the two magnets are there, suppose the bar magnets are there, if you want to store it properly, suppose these are the magnet. So if you want to store this magnet, these are the bar magnet, if you want to store it, you have to keep in the box in such a way that between these a keeper should be kept. Keeper. Now what is meant by the keeper? Keeper means which is made up of wood or the material which does not attract towards the magnet. You can take a plastic, or you can take any wood. Are you getting? So you have to keep a keeper, magnetic keeper. Okay, then in that, the second magnet which you are going to keep, you have to keep south north in a one box. If you want to keep the two magnets, then one you have to keep north south and another you have to keep it south north, so it does not lose its magnetism. Okay, so you have to store the magnet properly. Are you getting? Unlike poles are on the two unlike poles are on the same side, then you have to separate it by the material, or you have to keep some material which will not lose its magnetism. So this is how we have to take care of the magnet. Are you getting? Properly. So this was about a magnetism. In the next lesson, we are going to learn the concept of electricity, and that time we will understand, or we will go more in detail with the electromagnet, and I'm going to show how does the electric bell, it works on which principle? Electric bell works on the electromagnet, so that the work through working you will be able to understand the actual working of the electromagnet. Are you getting? So today's work is that how to take care of the magnet, how the magnetism is destroyed, that you have to write in notebook. Read the lesson thoroughly of magnetism, which is in your CBSE book. Read thoroughly twice, remove the notes, try to understand, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you, my dear students.